Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another Genshin Impact video, guys. We have the new event wish sparkling steps boost the drop rate for fleeing sunlight glee, and this is going to be the banner for glee rerun that's going to be out just as soon as patch 1.6 for Genshin Impact is going to be out. And it's going to have Fischl, Sucrose and Barbara for the banner. And I mean, the 4 stars, kind of meh. You should already have official for the event that you did. Sucrose is amazing. So good. I can never, ever, ever, ever recommend her enough. She's so good. And I highly, 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 highly suggest, if you do not have a Sucrose, try one multi one. Just for the chance to have Sucrose. She's really good. She replaces Venti. Of course, Venti is like overly strong. He's the double S in my opinion, Venti is, but Sucrose is a really good replacement for your animal batteries, for just grouping up enemies together and bringing them together, or wait for it, Kazaha can do the same thing. So if you guys don't want Klee, want Sucrose, it might be an okay idea to try to get Kazaha. Obviously none of them are guaranteed. Kazaha is at least somewhat guaranteed in 180 wishes. Sucrose is not. Keep that in mind as we move on. Anyways, I can't really give like a stronger opinion about that. But yeah, moving on. The new weapon banner is out with Lost Prayer to the Sacred Winds, which is the best in slot for Klee, as well as the Skyward Pride, which is the best in slot for a character like Beidou. You could also use it for youll if you want that energy recharge and for have her ult be up more times. Anyways, we have Fischl's new weapon. I'm gonna try rolling on this banner maybe one time just to try and get this weapon. It's so dope. It's so dope. And I kind of want to try. But Lion's Roar, good for Kaching, sucks for everyone else. Favonius, good for the Zhongli mains who just use him as a support. Or just for, you know, for the ult to go off. The Wood Sith, also good for Mona. Klee's alright as well. The Bells. Moving on, we have the entire Mid-Island Adventure event. And you can also pre-install the game immediately. It is for after tomorrow, so it's when the update rolls out. It's estimated to take 5 hours. Compensation would be 300 Prima Gems, the usual. And all travelers who are ranked whatever can get it. New limited time area, that sucks a lot. No one likes limited time areas, that sucks. So yeah, in order to unlock this limited time area, you need to complete Klee's story quest and the prologue act 3 for the Arcan quest. So the new character, quote unquote, is going to be Kazaha, which is going to be on the second banner coming after Klee. Now, obviously, you guys saw him. He's going to come with a new weapon, which is the Freedom Sworn. The other new weapon, which is going to be on the first banner, is the Mitternacht Waltz. Sorry, I'm unable to say this, but it's Fischl's Bow. And we have the Dodo Coattails, which is for Klee. Alright, so we got the new Serenity Teapot stuff. We got the dressing room for the outfits for Barbara and Jean. And we got the new event stuff that happens. This is everything that's gonna go on for the entirety of the Genshin Impact event, which is very nice. Alright, so this is your... You need to be Adventure Rank 21 to be eligible for any rewards. Act 1, Main Cannon, Make Ready Fire. So during this event, Mysterious Islands. Alright, so this is just all the stuff that's gonna be going on. Obviously, we're not gonna talk about all of them now. If you guys want to see any of this, pause it here. I'm not gonna be reading through all of them. All right, the new event for the Echoing Tales. This is how you can get Barbara's outfit, so make sure you guys do this for the Prima Gems as well as the outfit. Just do it, okay? It's a free skin, okay? All right, we got a new Arcan quest. It's called Chapter 2 Prologue Autumn Wind Scarlet Leaves. I'm not sure if this is instantly gonna come on 1.6. I'm hoping it is. If it is, great, fantastic. But yeah, all right new limited time world quests, Addition Beyond Mortal Ken. All right so there's just some world quests, but it is limited time, so you can't really do them afterwards. Magu Kenki, which is a new boss, and this is some other additions. There's going to be a new gadget, which is the Windblessed Harp Pastime, New recipes, furnishings, new achievements, name cards, whatever it may be. You guys can pause to see what it is. Anyways, this is the really important thing. This is the meat, honestly. Floor 11 Leyline Disorder is changed. This increases swirl damage by 300% and its AoE by 100%. This is insane. So they're trying to really push Kazuha here. It's very obvious that they're trying to push Kazuha. But what I'm looking forward to is how much damage my Venti and Sucrose are going to do. And my Zhao. My Zhao is going to go crazy here. So I cannot wait to see what it does. Alright, so they're going to update the entirety of the Spiral Abyss for Floor 9, 10, 11, and 12. Thank God. That took way too long for them to do any of that. God dang. Not gonna talk about that more. It's doo-doo, man. They took way too long on it. The 1.5, 11, and 12 change is very needed and very good. But they just needed to change all the monsters and stuff for all the floors. And I cannot wait to try the new Spiral Abyss. Alright. Phase 1, Whirlpool Moon. So this is the first Spiral Abyss, quote-unquote, buff that they give you, and every time you do swirl, it's gonna trigger an AoE. All right, and then a swirl, it's all going to be swirl. When an active character triggers a swirl, I got lost. When an active character triggers a swirl reaction on a nearby opponent, you're gonna get a shockwave, which is the AoE. And then in phase 2, which is called Breeze Called Moon, active character does swirl, it will regenerate more particles. And then for 3, when an active character does swirl to a nearby opponent, it's gonna do an aura, and the aura will inflict like dot damage, I think. The aura will inflict one count of damage to opponents within it every once every 2 seconds. So yeah, it damage over time. Yada yada. This is really important. Every time you press the L key on PC, it's gonna open up the party setup screen. This is excellent. O opens friend screen, also really good. You can auto lock 4-star weapons in the settings. Alright, that's cool, and you can turn it off. Low limit for serenity path is increased. 4-star artifacts can be destroyed in return for more. Pretty big. Crafting or forging can be performed in co-op mode. This is big. This is big. Thank God. Travelers returning through their own world can obtain the forging rewards. Thank you. This is so good. That's really good. Co-op mode adds status markers when teammates are switching characters. That's cool. All right, this is also pretty chain. That this is big. This is the other, the one they put at the very end. This is probably the biggest thing. Adjust the description of the food item. And the yeah. Increases the damage caused by major reactions, which is this is that. It still didn't tell us any of how much it increases. Increase the base shield damage absorbed from shield generated by crystallized reactions. Increases the damage provided by elemental mastery for major reaction. Refer to the attributes panel in game for the exact damage bonus amount. Alright, cool. So this is just increase the amount. They don't tell us how much. Kind of sucks. But yeah. Alright, it just looks fantastic. And I cannot wait to do all this stuff. Act 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, there's no 5. It's just 4. So 4 acts for the entirety of this event. I think we have covered it all. Yep, we have covered it all. Yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching this video. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, tell me what you guys think in the comment section below. And I'll try to reply to most of you guys. If you guys can, please consider liking and subscribing to my channel. That's going to be super helpful to me. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for 350 subscribers. That's insane. We're moving up in the world. Thank you guys so much, and see you guys in the next video very soon. Goodbye.